Well, hello and welcome to our Thursday edition of Evening Jesus. You know, we've been walking through some of the names of Jesus that we discover from an ancient Hebrew prophet named Isaiah who lived 2,600 years ago. And the passage we've been looking at, it's often read during the Christmas season, but really, there's never a bad time to uncover what the names associated with Jesus tell us about the one we follow. Here's what Isaiah wrote all those years ago. For to us a child is born, to us a son is given, and the government will be on his shoulders. And he will be called Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. Okay, so far we've looked at Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, and tonight let's talk about the Prince of Peace. What does it mean that Jesus was the Prince of Peace? And what's meant by the word peace anyway? And what does all of this mean for how you and I are meant to live? See, the concept of peace is just much bigger than the absence of conflict or a ceasefire in war. And here's why. Isaiah uses the Hebrew word shalom that we translate into peace. And shalom is just so much more expansive than what you and I would typically think about when we think about the word peace. See, shalom refers to a state of profound wholeness, openness, harmony. Shalom is about having our relationships properly ordered, our relationship with ourselves, with others, with creation, and even with God himself. So to say Jesus is the Prince of Peace is to say that Jesus is the Prince of Shalom, that Jesus came to bring harmony and wholeness to the world. But here's the thing, he did not just bring it about, he is peace. Shalom is Jesus's character. And he brings about this peace, he brings about this shalom in a way that honestly the world did not expect, and that honestly you and I still don't expect. He does it not by crushing his enemies, but by being willing to die at the hands of his enemies. And the reason for this is that the ends cannot be different from the means. You cannot obtain peace by means of violence, right? This is what the broken record of history tries to teach us, that violence always eventually begets more violence. And here's the thing. You and I are meant to adopt Jesus's posture of shalom. In fact, here's what a man named Paul wrote about how we are to respond to Jesus, our Prince of Peace. Here's what Paul wrote. Follow God's example. Therefore, as dearly loved children, and walk in the way of love, just as Christ loved us and gave himself up for us as a fragrant offering and sacrifice to God. We're to follow Jesus. We're to be imitators of Jesus. See, a follower of Jesus is best defined by our willingness to imitate the one who went to the furthest possible extremes on behalf of other people. Shalom lurks different in different circumstances. If one is lonely, well, letting shalom flow through you is for them to be welcomed in. If someone's hungry, it's to feed them. If they're homeless, it's to provide shelter and clothing and shower, right? But here's the thing, it's consistent throughout with shalom. It's always other-oriented, right? It's always other-oriented. It's always about practicing self-sacrificial love for them. So what does shaloming look like for you, for us, during this pandemic? How can we muster all of our creative potential to bring shalom to our community? Hey, thanks for joining me, guys, and I will see you tomorrow night.